It's time for your snack. Are you hungry?
I guess, a little.
Let's see what we can find in the kitchen. Here, Sean. Here's your snack.
Thanks, Dad.
What do you say we play together for a while?
I'd rather watch TV.
How are things at school? Is your teacher nice?
Everything's fine, Dad.
So, do you want to talk a little?
Talk about what?
I don't know, about you, your friends. How things are going?
Nothing special.
You've got a cold coming on. I'm gonna see if I can find some medicine for you. When the parents came home from church, all their children were gone. They searched and called for them, they cried and begged, but it was all to no avail. The children have never been seen again. Thank you.
Sean, do you want to do your homework now?
Please, Dad, let me watch TV a little while longer. We'll do it later, okay?
I think we should just get right to it. Then it's done and out of the way. Now, get your bag and get set up in the kitchen. I'll help you.
Can I go watch TV?
Let me have a look. Pretty good. Looks like you're done. Off you go. Here, take this. It'll make you feel better.
Thanks, Dad.
Do you want me to get your dinner?
Oh, yeah. I'm really hungry.
Okay, I'll go see what I can find. I'll call you when it's ready.
Thank you.
You can come now, Sean. Your meal is ready.
I'm coming!
I could shoot some hoops. Clears my head. Greece has Sean this weekend. Seems like he can't wait to get back to his mother. It's raining. I'd better get back inside.
Come on, Sean. It's time for bed.
I'm not tired yet. Can I stay up a little longer?
Now, that's not very reasonable, is it? You have school tomorrow. You have to get some sleep.
All right, I'm going. Are you coming with me?
Go brush your teeth and put on your pajamas. I'll come up. Thank you.
Thanks, Dad.
Good night, Sean.
Night. Dad?
Yeah?
Why do you look so sad?
I think I just need some time to get back to the way things were.
You know, Dad, what happened to Jason wasn't your fault.
Good night, Sean.
What the heck is happening to me? I must be going crazy.
Men at the desk got to be able to help. Been looking for weeks. Hope I hit pay dirt this time.
Lauren Winter. Ring any bells?
Nope. Can't say it does. Oh, that Lauren Winter. Third floor, last door on the left, at the end of the corridor.
Lauren Winter?
Sorry, I only see clients by appointment.
Wait.
It's $50. I don't kiss and I don't do any weird shit.
Fine by me.
Put your money on the table. You got exactly 10 minutes when the alarm rings, it's over, okay? You should take your clothes off. We ain't got all day.
Actually, I'm not a customer.
Ugh, shit, a cop. I should have known. What do you want, a freebie? Is that it?
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. The families of the victims of the origami killer asked me to investigate the murders. I came here just to ask you some questions about Johnny.
I already told the police all I know and have nothing to add. Leave me alone.
I understand, Lauren. I know what you're going through.
Oh yeah? You know what it feels like to find your own son's body on a wasteland? I'm sorry, I don't believe you have the slightest idea what I'm going through, Mr. Shelby.
The killer is walking around free as we speak. He'll kill again if he's not arrested.
My Johnny's dead, so what difference does it make?
If we don't find the killer, there'll be other mothers who find their son's body on a deserted wasteland. But you're right. Why should you care? It's not your problem anymore, right?
What do you want to know?
Did Johnny live with you?
Yes. Of course, I made sure he never met any of my clients. I wanted to stop, you know. But we needed the money. I was trying to earn enough to get us out of here.
Tell me about Johnny. What kind of kid was he?
Johnny was really a good boy. Sometimes he fought with other kids who called me a, you know. In his own way, I think he understood what was going on. You want one?
No thanks, I quit.
That's brave.
Tell me about Johnny's father.
A loser without a job who liked to beat me after a few drinks. He left the day Johnny disappeared. I ain't seen him since. Coward. Good thing he left.
Did you suspect anyone after he disappeared?
I meet a lot of pretty shady characters in my line of work. Sure, I thought of it at first. But it didn't seem to make any sense. I don't believe any of my clients could have done that to my Johnny and all those other kids. Time's up, Mr. Shelby. I hope you got what you wanted. Now get out of here.
Well, if you remember anything, the smallest detail, give me a call. No point in pushing it. She's not going to tell me anymore. I didn't learn squat. Well, it's worth a try. I gotta get out of here.
What are you doing here? I already told you, I don't want to see you anymore.
Sorry, Dal, but I really wanted to see you. What do you want, asshole?
Lauren, is everything all right?
She's just swell. Now beat it, loser! Again? If you're looking for trouble, you found it. I'm gonna beat the shit out of you. Oh! Again, asshole.
Are you all right?
Better than him, I guess. Who is he?
An ex-client who thinks he owns me. He was getting violent, and I told him I didn't want to see him anymore.
Well, you should be careful. He'll probably be back. Sorry about the mess.
Mr. Shelby?
Yeah.
Thanks.
noted that name somewhere. What was it? Blake. Lieutenant Carter Blake. Yeah, that's it. God, my hands are trembling. I gotta keep my act together. At least for now. Goddamn rain. Hasn't stopped pouring since I arrived. I'm really gonna love it here. Reporters? Already? You seem well informed.
Zone is sectioned off, sir. Please step back.
Agent Norman Jaden, FBI.
You got a badge or something, Mr. Jaden?
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
Check. You can pass.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Blake. Is he around?
I saw him arrive earlier. He's here somewhere.
Thanks. Video memo recording, Agent 47023, Norman Jaden, Tuesday, October 4th, 2011. Time is 8:14 a.m.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Carter Blake. Thanks.
Sample of no interest. Comes from one of the policemen present on the wasteland. Unrelated to the investigation.
Harry comment. Sample of no interest. Comes from one of the policemen present on the wasteland.
Some orchid pollen. The concentration of pollen in the air is quickly decreasing because of the rain, but it gets higher in the direction of the body.
Sample of no interest. Comes from one of the policemen present on the wasteland. Lieutenant Blake, I'm Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI. I went by your office this morning, they told me you'd be here.
Now, if you're looking for rain, dead bodies, and highways, you come to the right place. Mike, will you tell that asshole with the bulldozer to stop for 5 minutes? I can't hear myself think here.
Right away, Lieutenant.
Well, are you coming, Jaden?
So, what happened?
Some guy taking his dog for a piss found a body about 6 o'clock this morning. We don't know much more right now. Based on what we've seen, looks like the work of the origami killer.
Has the body been identified?
No, not yet. We should know more later today. Any news on the coroner?
He's on his way, Lieutenant.
We've been waiting for an hour, for fuck's sake.
Has the time of death been established?
Based on the rigor mortis, must be less than 6 hours ago. We should know more once the coroner has had a look.
Any witnesses?
None yet. Given the neighborhood, I'd be surprised if anybody saw anything. Tony, I don't want to see a single shit-stirring journalist within a mile of here. You got it?
Yes, Lieutenant.
Do you have any leads?
My men are going over the scene with a fine-tooth comb. If the killer left anything behind, we'll find it.
Do we know the cause of death?
There are no marks on the body. Chances are he was drowned, like the others. Listen, I'm a little busy here. Why don't we discuss all this a little later, back at the office?
Oh, no problem. I understand. Do you mind if I have a look around?
Be my guest. Hey, Jaden, you come and see me if you find anything, okay? We're on the same team now.
When did they find the body?
Excuse me, but who are you exactly?
Norman Jaden, FBI.
If you want to ask questions, you should speak to Lieutenant Blake, sir.
Lousy weather, huh? Does it always rain like this?
It rains every fall. Doesn't it do that where you come from?
Yeah. Yeah, of course. Is that a coffee you're drinking there?
There's some in the thermos behind you. Help yourself.
Pretty chilly, huh?
common. Pollen particles disappear in the tall grass. It's probably the end of the trail. Harry, common. Traces of blood on the railroad track. The blood report indicates an advanced and long-lasting state of exhaustion. Footprints continue just after the pollen trail. There's a good chance that they're the killers. Harry, comment. Traces of blood detected on the fence behind the railroad line. Harry, comment. The victim is lying on his back. No visible signs of violence. An orchid was placed on the victim's chest. A small origami figure in the right hand. Fingers were probably closed after the time of death. The victim is Jeremy Bowles, declared missing 5 days ago. See reference file. Superficial wound on the right thigh. The blood is identical to that on the fence. His face is covered with mud, like the other victims. Dead cat. The FBI doesn't keep files on dead cats. Not yet.
There's a good chance that they're the killers. Tracks on the side of the boat behind the railroad line. It may be the killer's car.
I think I've seen all there is to see.
Heading back to the office. You staying?
No, I've seen enough. I'm leaving too.
Way too many people here. They're trampling all over the crime scene. Nah, I think I've seen enough. Better get back to the station before I catch pneumonia. There's a railroad track near where the body was left. Same as all the other victims.